Antiques Roadshow host Mark L. Wahlberg took a quick break to share some of his favorite Wisconsin experiences.
My favorite part probably was the fried cheese curds, which I'm sure you're tired of hearing about, but for those of us who don't live here, it's a big, you know, delicacy.
That's right.
So I was at Wisconsin Dells on Thursday and loved that. I'd heard about it but never been there, and learned that it's, I think, like the 12th biggest or most popular vacation spot in the world.
And the water park capital of the world.
So I've heard. I didn't partake of the water park, but everything else. And then I went to the House of the Rock yesterday, which I'm still trying to get my head around. And today we talked about some artifacts thefts that happened a few years ago here at the Historical Society, and what efforts are being done to get them back.
Excellent. So since you've been hosting Antiques Roadshow, when you came in, what surprised you most about the production process?
Well, you know, I've been at television a long, long, long time. So I can't say a whole lot surprised me when I went to see the television stuff, but the vibe is different. It's not so much a television show, it's more a little bit like summer camp. Everybody's here having a great time, and you know, nobody rushes through the day, and it's not, everybody's got the same spirit, and that's what I really love about it.
And for someone who isn't able to come and attend a taping in person, what might surprise them that they see, because it's very different than what they see on TV, but some parts are the same.
Yeah, it's interesting because you don't get to see the whole scope. What you really love to see is a camera from the top and looking down at the whole thing. I don't think people realize the scope of things, how many people come through. 6,000 people will come through, and that everything's happening so fast, you know, that all those people standing behind what you're watching on television are actually getting appraisals, and that's for real. So I think people might be surprised by that.
Have you ever brought an item and gone through the appraisal process?
No, within minutes of getting the job, you know, or showing up to the first Antiques Roadshow taping, I realized that sadly I own nothing of value.
So nothing you can even imagine that would have.
Nothing.
What's been the most, if there's one thing that has amazed you most that you've seen people, because I mean, the scope of things that they bring in here is amazing.
Yeah, it really is. I couldn't really point to one thing. I mean, it's overwhelming how many things come through. Plus, the work that I do is a lot of time off-site, so I don't get to see as much stuff as the appraisers do. But to me, my memories are always the people that I meet. So.
And there's lots of, that's the thing that strikes me, I think, is everybody's happy, even when they find out that what they thought might have been worth.
Well, you got to remember, 6,000 people, we may tape 80 of them. So a lot of people better come just for the fun, because they obviously have something that's precious to them, but possibly not financially valuable. And so that is the overwhelming consensus, that people are here to have a good time. And more often than not, they do.